Hey, how you guys doing? This is William Myers from Mantis Outdoors, and what we got going on today is I'm going to show you guys an improvised fishing pole, kind of a step above a cane pole. And you know, a cane pole is great. You know, improvised fishing, just go with minimal kit, attach a line to a cane, throw it out, get some fish. But you know, you kind of lack versatility in a way, and that's what I'm going to show you guys today, a little bit, a pole that you can make with simple material that has a little bit more versatility in it. So don't go away.
Bye. Bye.
Got the kids out today. Out in the woods with me. Got some lessons going on. Some fire making and stuff like that.
I made a fire.
And they're dying to get in camera. So give them their 15 minutes here.
Everybody back up. Everybody back up.
Okay. All right, guys, so I just selected this maple here, and it's gonna do the job. I mean, that's pretty sturdy, so it's gonna do what I want. But you know, it's all gnarled up. It's got some gnarly little knots on it, stuff like that, and the bark as well. So I'm gonna take the dark timber. Everybody loves to see the dark timber, bushcrafter. It's one of my favorite knives. And I'm just gonna clean up all the bark and take all the knots off and things like that. For the bark, I'm just gonna use the spine of the knife. I'm gonna get in here, take all that bark off. If I hit a knot, just come through with this. This dude is deadly sharp, so doesn't take nothing. But I want to save the edge for knots, and just if it's nothing but bark, I'll just take that off with the spine. If you leave that bark on and you're fishing all day long, it'll blister you up. So a couple knots. Oops, sorry, buddy.
You're good.
All right, so I'm gonna finish clearing this stick up. You know, it's gonna take me a couple minutes. I don't want that all to be on camera. It'd be kind of boring. And we'll get back to you when I'm done. All right, guys, so as you can see, I'm done stripping all the bark off of this. You know, it's got a couple hairs. It doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be manageable. I don't like keeping the bark on because, like I said, if I'm fishing all day long, that bark's going to blister me up. It's going to tear me up. This is a little bit better. But, you know, I could, like I said, I could just very easily put some line on here and run it down, say, to here for a safety catch, and that'd be just a regular old cane pole. The safety catch is so if the fish breaks my pole, I still have some tied on down here. I still have my fish, you know, and then I could get out into the water, things like that. But if I want to get around a tree in the water or an obstacle in the water, something like that, I'm going to want something that has a little bit more versatility. And, you know, fishing poles in themselves, they're a pain to pack, you know, but I can make something that's just like a fly fishing rod, pretty much for the most part, with just some simple tools that I have down here. All right, so what I'm gonna need for this project is some duct tape, some Gorilla Tape, and I prefer what's attached to the side of my haversack here with these clamps is this one inch stuff right here. But if I run out of this stuff, which I'm looking like I'm going to, I'm gonna have to pick up some more here in a little bit at Walmart when we leave tomorrow. I do have this 2-inch stuff here that I can tear in half and I can still make that serviceable. So duct tape, Gorilla Tape, whatever you wanna call it, my sewing kit that I keep, and I'm going to show you why this is going to be important, and a multi-tool. So first of all, what I'm going to need is to take my thumb thimble, I guess, for, you know, I use this piece of leather for pushing needles and such through so they don't stab me. And what I keep in my sewing kit is a bunch of safety pins. And I keep them in there so I can, you know, safety pin, obviously, if you've sewn anything ever, you know, you safety pin things together, sew them, then remove the safety pins. So I'm going to take three of these safety pins out, just like that. And then I'm going to put everything back away. And I always keep plenty of those safety pins. Put that back in my pocket. Alright, so what I'm going to do starting out on this project is I'm going to take my multi-tool and the clippers there. And I'm going to clip the safety pin as close to the head as I can. Just like that, okay? Alright. And then I'm going to take and I'm going to squeeze this together. I'm going to come up here and I'm going to get a 90 degree bend on this. Just like that. And I think you all can see what I've just done there. I just created a fishing eye to a fishing pole. So let's attach this to our fishing pole. Okay. All right, so I'm going to get about a 2 or 3 inch strip off my haversack here. And I love having this outside the haversack. If it does start raining and I'm hiking, I'll either put on my poncho and this goes underneath my poncho, or I'll just take the tape off and put it in my bag. But I like having this easy access right here. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this directly on this eye, just like this. And then we're going to attach it on the pole where we want it. I want it about right there. And that end to the fishing pole we're actually going to clip with our knife. So get this nice and sturdy, tight. You don't want this to be able to move at all. That tight on there. You also don't want any of the tape sticking up because the tape will grab the fishing line, as I'm sure you guys could think. You helping me, buddy?
Yep.
Okay. All right, watch out so they can see. All right, so there's one. And you can see what I've done. And like I said, I'm going to clip that end of the fishing pole off with my knife. All right, so just kind of trimming up the end of that fishing pole so the line doesn't catch. You know, I could have done this before, but I just kind of wanted to see where I wanted to put that eye. And that'll work right about there. I just want to make sure that nothing catches when I'm casting. All right. All right, so now I'm gonna put another one, probably about 3 or 4 feet down here, and I'm gonna put my last one about 3 or 4 foot down here. All right, guys, so once again, just clipping this as far back as I can. And taking that pretty close up, right about there, and getting that nice 90 degree angle on it. And, you know, I'd like to come back a little bit if I had longer safety pins, but, you know, I use what I have. I'd like to give this a little bit more room up top, but I also want them to be, I want them to have enough purchase on the tape and the wood to be secure. So you kind of just got to use what you have. So let me get another piece of tape here. I want this piece of tape to be just a bit longer because I want it to be a little bit more secure. Line it up with my pole. Like I said, guys, I have my kids out in the woods with me as always, so if you hear kids back in the background, that's what's going on. They're out playing in the woods like they should be. All right, get my tape on the guide itself. Line it up real nice. Doesn't have to be absolutely straight perfect, but I like to be a little decent at least. Right about there will work. Nice and tight on the wood. Wrap it nice and tight.
Dad, this one was not that tight.
Yeah, it's pretty tight. It'll work. You second guessing me? All right, that's not going anywhere. That's not going anywhere. One more. We don't have to do this one on camera, but I'll be right back with you and we'll show you the completed pole. All right, so if I can find into my line here, I'm just going to attach it with a simple clove hitch and then do some security wraps around it.
You got a long ways to go.
It's all right.
Excuse the noise, the kids are playing in the background.
Just doing what kids are supposed to do.
Soccer. You gonna cut that out?
No.
No.
I don't mind kids playing in the background. That's what they're supposed to be doing.
Dad, tell me if you need the bottom of the fishing boat.
Okay, baby.
Alright, so what kind of knot is this?
This is a clove hitch. And then I'm just going to do a security hitch behind that, or what would be called as a crown. If you're doing a clove hitch and then a security hitch behind it, that would be a crown, but I'm not proper knot expert, I guess you could say, but that's what it is.
I don't know my knots at all.
Owen, don't play soccer.
You don't know much in the bush.
No, I don't.
You refuse to learn.
Owen, don't play soccer.
There's a wide world of gaming out there
yeah.
for me.
Expert gamer.
Yes.
Dad, what are these?
Sinkers, put it down, baby.
It's too much Doctor Who that needs watched.
Yeah. All right, so besides my wife's rambling, just get this secured to the back of the pole. Then just treat it like any other fishing pole. Where the leader goes top. Find the end of my line here. It's going to be a second.
Do 12 hours later.
You watch too much SpongeBob with the kids. Wow. Wow.
Yeah, you're married to me. You're stuck. You're stuck
like
with
that.
Me.
All right, so we're just going to treat it just like any other fish pole. Go through our eyes here. There we go.
Ooh, something's there.
That's a bug. You're out in the woods.
Dive bomb my ear.
Bugs are going to get you.
Yes, I know.
And before anybody asks, yes, this is tried and tested. I have tested this. It does work. I've caught a decent little catfish on it. It wasn't the hugest thing in the world, but I'm confident.
Mama! Okay, hang on, Evie. Get your shoe back on, please.
All right, here we go. So we're gonna attach some weight to this, and we'll get right back to you.
Two, one. All right. So what we basically made at this point is sort of a fly rod. You know, it's something that has just a little bit more versatility when we're fishing in tight spots, stuff like that. When we got to get around certain obstacles or something like that. You know, it's something that gives us just a little bit more versatility. Get a little cast. That one was horrible. Cast, you know, it's not like something, you know, I just kind of drag it in with my hands. If I get a bite, that, you know, I'm gonna have to hold it to the pole and reel it in by my hand, or wrap it around a stick or what have you. I've done that before, but like I said, this just gives me a little bit more versatility, not only to get around obstacles in the water, but it gives me a little bit more versatility when it comes to the fishing tackle that I have, because at this point now I have time in the water. I could get a good cast out, and then I could, you know, jig. I can use spinner baits, et cetera, et cetera. Gotta get that off the top there. You You know, I do apologize for not being at the water's edge right now, but I'm at the park showing my kids some fire making skills and things like that. Obviously, you can hear them in the background. Let's get another cast in here. Good cast, good cast. You know, all that I do basically is I put the pole into my hip and I drag it in with my hands. Like I said, if I get a bite, then I'll set the hook and I'll either spin it into my hand. If I feel that it's a huge fish, I usually have a stick of some kind in my pocket and I'll reel it in with that stick. I'll wrap it around that stick. So like I said, this just gives me a little bit of time in the water. It gives me a little bit more versatility to use, you know, spinner baits, jigs, et cetera, things like that. And there are weights back. But there's one more thing that we could do to make this even more versatile, and I'll show you that here in a second. Okay. All right, guys, so obviously you can see in my hand that I have a fishing reel. It's kind of a big fishing reel, not exactly perfect for the application that I'm gonna be doing, but it's what I have, and it's what I'm gonna use what I have. So very simple, I'm sure you guys can see where I'm going with this. I'm just gonna attach this to the makeshift pole that I've made. Let's go show you that. All right, so I'm just gonna get a nice big strip of this 2-inch tape, and I'm gonna cut this in half. I hate when it happens. Let's lay this right here.
And now that looks like a piece of this tape.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Alright, so our fishing line getting kind of tangled up. Let's pull it out on this side. Put probably a little too much line on this thing, but I like to have the option of curling it up, winding it up on the bottom. Alright, anyway. So I'm going to take my knife. I'm going to cut that clove hitch that I put on there, releasing it from the pole. I'm going to take my knife and I'm going to make a nice square notch. Right in here. Just rocking back and forth to go through the fibers of the wood. And the square notch is going to be big, so I'm going to have to take it off in two sections. That's no worries. Uh-oh. You know, you got to be mindful of what your application is, because if I make this square notch too deep, I'm not going to be able to use it the way that I want to. It's just going to butt up against the end of the reel. So, clear that square notch out a little bit with the tip of that blade. You know, the basis of this, somebody's going to say, hey, why not just pack a pole? Well, packing a fishing pole is certainly not my most favorite thing in the world to do. They're cumbersome, they don't pack very well. But a fishing reel, that's nothing to pack, really. All right, so obviously you can see what we're going on with this. We've got to set that right in that square notch, just like that, and then we're just gonna duct tape it. So let's do that now.
They're calmly Mars.
No, Corbin.
Hang on, Corbin.
Wait, Corbin. I know you want to help, buddy. Just hang on.
Daddy, do that side first.
Yeah. I'm just making it straight. So I can do it better.
Wait. You helping me out, buddy?
Oh, he's trying
to get all the stuff off the...
It's okay.
Duct tape.
It's not a big deal. Stuff that gets attached to this stuff. That's why it's so sticky. Gorilla tape. It's good stuff, huh, buddy?
Yeah.
You know, I don't think that we really need this second piece, but I mean, I'm not gonna let it go to waste. So let's put it on. And wrap this way. You know, it's not going to look beautiful, but it's going to work.
Dad, can you make it so it's camo?
Camo? What, you want me to spray paint it camo?
Yeah.
You're goofy.
You love camo, don't you?
Yep.
It's pretty fun. Nope. Yeah, there's lots of mosquitoes today, huh, buddy?
Yeah.
All right, so basically what we've made, fishing pole. Let's line it up, cast a few times. All right, guys, so here you have it. You know, it ain't the most beautiful thing in the world. I would definitely say that this qualifies as an ugly stick. But, you know, she'll work. She'll do what we need to do. Beautiful, beautiful. You know what, I would much rather pack, probably not this, probably something like a bait caster or something a little bit smaller. But again, I wanted to show you guys how to do this and just had this laying around, so I used it. So I would much rather pack just the reel. You gonna live? I would much rather pack just the reel and, you know, some safety pins, some duct tape, than pack a whole fishing rod, you know, and this works just perfect. Alright guys, this has been William Myers from Mantis Outdoors. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, there's some more of my previous videos that are playing in the screens to my left right now. There's also a subscribe button over there. If you haven't done so, I appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel. To stay up to date with what I'm doing with my school and the YouTube channel, stay posted on the videos that are going to be uploaded. You can go to www.facebook.com/Mantis Outdoors, or you can go to www.mantisoutdoorsllc.com. Liking my videos helps me and my channel out a lot. I appreciate all your views, comments, and support, and hopefully we'll see you out in the woods.